Happy 4th of July, and welcome to Monday with Michelle on Out Late But Great. Actually, don't tell anybody, but it's actually Sunday the 3rd. But I was feeling very frisky today and had a great day of creativity out and about with my lovely wife and her cousin. We had a very Kerouac sort of day, and we're driving all over town, enjoying sitting in the most awesome new bookstore that's just opened, reading, talking to the owners, sharing our creative thoughts, and it was just an awesome day. So I decided that I was going to come down to my studio and make a video. Happy 4th of July. Hope everybody is doing well. I hope that you all enjoyed that fantastic week that we had last week of all the reminiscing and, as Sid put it, kissing each other's butts, which, you know, I didn't really consider it like kissing up, but it's just, I really am so happy that we all find our strength through everybody on this channel and all the support and feedback we get. It's really fantastic, and I just want to thank all of you from the bottom of my heart for all the beautiful things that you said. It meant so much to me. So before I start crying, I'm going to read this week's topic. Jim from Georgia selected this topic, and he says here, selected a topic proposed by Tracy, so he wants Tracy to get credit for these ideas. Okay, recently New York passed the marriage equality bill, finally making it legal for same-sex couples to get married in their state. So let's tackle and discuss some of the different angles of the New York marriage victory. Here are some to consider, but we might choose others. So I'm just going to run down the list here. Should we thank Republicans for voting yes, or was their move a political calculation? Well, I definitely want to say thank you to the Republicans. And I thought that was really cool. So that right there, hearing that quote from him, that makes me think that it was not based on political calculation. However, even if it was, well, I will welcome all the Republicans to start passing gay rights bills to get our votes. Go for it. You know, really. I mean, whatever it takes. If the Republicans all of a sudden want to start having all the votes from the LGBTQ community, rock on. I told you I was feeling frisky tonight. How did I feel at the announcement? Where or what were you doing when you heard? Okay, I was elated, of course, as anybody who is for rights, civil rights of any kind. What was I doing when I heard? I was actually checking my Facebook. And I think I saw something from HRC or one of the marriage equality things that I've, you know, kind of friended on Facebook. And I read something, and then I had to, like, you know, all of a sudden look at the news, and then I realized that the New York bill had passed, and it was a Friday. And unfortunately, my wife was on her way out of town. She was already gone, but I texted her, and we talked, and we were just so excited. Just so very excited, because you know, by watching this channel, my wife and I got married last October. No, it is not legal in the state of Florida. Did we care? No. I have been married before. but Kirsten had not. And I wanted her to have that experience of picking out her dress, the cake, all that stuff. It's like a, it's not really a rite of passage, but it's such a beautiful celebratory time of your life. And in our case, it took a whole year to plan the wedding. Seriously, a whole year. For all of you people out there that are planning a wedding, no matter what your orientation, give yourselves a good year, because then you can pace yourselves and not rush. And when the day comes, it's just this beautiful celebration. What do you think about all the negative, hateful comments to follow the announcement? Well, you know, with every rite that we get, there are going to be people who are totally as excited about squashing us as we are excited about having the rite. And I'm sure there's plenty of people out there right now that are planning in their little devious minds on how to turn this around, such as a Prop 8 in California. You know, what can I say? The people that are against us, they're always going to be against us until they have someone in their family that's gay. And it'll happen. It'll happen. Do you think the right will regroup and the pendulum of public opinion swing their way? Now, I don't know if Jim meant this just about New York or about marriage rights in general, but I'd like to see someone try to take that right away from New Yorkers right now. No way. I think there would be such an uprising that I would hope that now that they've passed it, that they, you know, they would have a hard time turning that around in their way. Okay, what is your prediction on when marriage will be legal in your state? Let me just read you a little something. 3 days after New York legalized gay marriage, Governor Rick Scott said this. Well, as you know, by the Constitution, that can't come here. So, it won't be. It's not really a discussion here. Okay, that was 3 days after New York passed. So do I think that Florida's next on the list? No. You know, whatever. I really want to see... Okay, and this is the portion where we're going to kind of go off on our own thing. I really want to see it become just a federal change. We have... I keep this little list that's been I've been keeping for many years, actually. We have Connecticut, Massachusetts, Iowa, Vermont, New Hampshire, D.C., Illinois has civil unions, New York now marriage rights. We did have California for the brief period between June and November of 08. We did have Maine, but that was repealed in November of 09. We have so many countries. I didn't write these down. Oh, yes, I did. I'm sorry. Argentina, Belgium, Canada, Iceland, the Netherlands, Norway, Portugal, parts of South Africa, Spain, Sweden. You know, all of these people must look at us, the supposedly one of the most powerful nations in the world, and think, you backward, you know, what's. I mean, I can't even imagine what it would be like to live in those countries and look at us and think, God, you guys are just really archaic. Because there are so many more important things to focus on. There was some talk of why they feel that Obama's kind of wishy-washy, but I think Obama, you know, and I'll probably be wrong about this, but I have a gut feeling that he is not going to go any further with rights until after the 2012 election. And it may kind of be a smart move. I don't know. It's hard to tell, you know, politics, you know. I know a lot of people are, you know, not really sure about what they think about Obama, but you can't deny that he has done more toward equality than any president that's been before him. Everything from turning around the don't ask, don't tell to signing the UN Declaration on Gay Rights. I'm reading some things I wrote down here. Expanded benefits for same-sex partners of federal employees. And right down to inviting gay couples to come to the White House at Easter. You know, I think deep in his heart, he probably doesn't care. I think he's just trying to play his cards right. So I am super excited about New York. And here's a little snippet from a very cute video that I saw. You really need to check this guy out. He's fantastic. I think this says it all. And I'm going to close with this snippet. So have a great week, everybody. And I look forward to seeing all the rest of the videos this week. Congratulations, New York. Carrying on, hoping there will come a day. Well, guess what? Today's the day. Today's the day. I'm 29.